When we talk about air quality, we're really talking about the health of the population as it has to breathe the air that we need to live. One of the real difficulties in helping people understand that air quality is a problem is that on a beautiful day, you may not see evidence of poor air quality, but it's there. You might be surprised to hear that the number of deaths in the United States per year attributed to air quality is estimated to be about 60,000. That's quite a few. I'm Jim Crawford. I'm the senior scientist here at NASA Langley Research Center for Atmospheric Chemistry. And my job as an atmospheric chemist, I work with a team of scientists trying to study air quality in the atmosphere. We do that with research aircraft. For a couple of decades now, we've really benefited from space in terms of satellite observations of air quality. But those observations have been from the low Earth orbit, where you get one look per day. And you can imagine that in terms of understanding a day in the life of a city, in terms of the early emissions in the morning from rush hour, and all the chemistry that takes place throughout the day, a lot can happen that we need to understand. What we're getting from TEMPO is both that continuity and the high resolution. It's important to recognize that TEMPO doesn't work alone. It has to be integrated into what we call the observing system. You have ground monitors, which are measuring at the highest precision what air quality conditions are. You have airborne measurements, which can't be done continuously, but can bring into the picture great information about the complexity of the air quality conditions and what's happening above our head, which plays a role in what we breathe down here. When we talk about air quality, it's not a problem that you simply solve at one moment in time. Human activity changes over time, populations shift, industries rise and fall. We really need to be able to monitor how those things are changing, because the air quality outcomes change in concert with the changes in what we put into the atmosphere. And so we don't need one look, we need continuous looks to be able to see and respond to what's happening in terms of atmosphere and its response to human emissions.